A very good morning, my dear students. Today's session, we are going to discuss the topic is valence bond theory. Valence bond theory. So regarding the valence bond theory, we'll see one question, right? Nickel CN4 minus 2, right? Diamagnetic valence nickel Cl4 minus 2 is paramagnetic. Explain. Right? The nickel CN4, the coordination sphere, charge minus 2, magnetic property is diamagnetic, whereas nickel Cl4, coordination sphere, charge minus 2 is paramagnetic. Explain. The question is based on valence bond theory. If we know the postulates of valence bond theory, we will solve it, right? So in the valence bond theory, by which we can find the hybridization and arrangement of orbitals, right? Then magnetic movement, magnetic properties and geometry, right? These are the terms, and now we can find it. So first, I am going to solve the first coordination sphere, right? Nickel CN4 minus 2. Actually, the IUPAC name of this complex, tetracyanidonickelate 2, right? Now, in the coordination sphere, first we have to find the oxidation state of nickel, right? The whole charge minus 2, the cyanido ligand, each ligand minus 1, so 4 ligand, so totally minus 4. When we add the plus 2 with the minus 4, we can get a minus 2, right? So nickel oxidation state plus 2. First you should write the nickel. The nickel is a center metal atom in the coordination sphere, right? So nickel electronic configuration, actually the nickel atomic number 28, right? According to the atomic number, we can write the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, then 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, right? Then 4s2, 3d8, right? Just we add 2 plus 2, 4, plus 6, 10, then 12, plus 6, 18, 20, then 28, right? The last orbital alone, we have to find a 4s2, 3d8. According to the ARPA principle, I write the electronic configuration. So we have to take the last orbit, 3d8 and 4s2, right? Now, what is the charge oxidation state of the nickel plus 2, right? So nickel oxidation state plus 2. What is the meaning of the plus 2? The last orbit, 4s2, it loses the two electrons. So after removing the 2 electron in the 4s orbit, so we can get a last orbit along 3d8 orbital, right? Then 4s 0. Now this outermost electronic configuration we can outermost electronic configuration we can mention in the orbital arrangement. Orbital arrangement. So first, for nickel plus 2, orbital arrangement, I am going to make it 3D8, means the d orbital we have known very well, 5 box, right? So next, the empty orbital, that is a s orbital, single box, right? Next, the vacant orbital will be there. After the 4s, 4p will be there, p orbital, right? So 3d, then 4s, then 4p. Now you can accommodate the electron. So here, with the filling electron, we have to follow Hund's rule. So 3d 8 means 8 electron we have to accommodate. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? 6, 7, 8. Now, so carefully we have to find it. The ligand, which type of ligand is present in the coordination sphere complex. Right? The CN, cyanido, is a strong ligand. Strong ligand going to make a bond with nickel means the unpaired electron make it to paired electron. Unpaired tends to pair, right? So the complex, now the complex is going to form the 4 cyanido is going to make a bond with the center metal atom. Now the arrangement, orbital arrangement is changed. The unpaired electron tends to pair electron. So again we have to write the 3D, 4S, 4P. The unpaired tends to pair because CN is a strong ligand. So again we can write 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So after the electron is pairing, unpaired tends to pairing, we can get an empty orbital in 3D, right? Now, how many cyanide is going to make a bond with the nickel? It makes a covalent coordinate bond. 4 cyanide. So each cyanide, cyanido, donate the lone pair electrons, right? So first cyanido, second cyanido, third cyanido, fourth cyanido. Here, the 2 electron can get from each cyanido. The symbol, I change it. So 2x symbol is given, there is an electron. Lone pair electron gets from cyanido. So first cyanido, second cyanido, third cyanido, then fourth cyanido. Okay, next step. Wherever the cyanido makes a bond in the central metal atom. So what are the orbital? So one d orbital, right? And one s orbital and two p orbital, right? So configuration, it's not a configuration, hybridization, 1d, 1s and 2p. So we can get dsp2 hybridization. As I told earlier, by the valence bond theory we can get the hybridization also, right? So dsp2 hybridization means the geometry, how will be totally d1, s1, p2, 4 dots, right? So nickel will be center, so each cyanide present at the corner, right? Actually, what is the structure? Square planar, right? So next, Bohr method on value, mu s value, we have to find it. So mu s, what is the formula? Root n into n plus 2. Bohr magneton. So Bohr magneton value. So here, in the orbital arrangement for the complex, how many unpaired electron is present? Any unpaired electron is present? We have to check it. After the 4 cyanido is involved in the bonding, can we find any unpaired electron? So no unpaired electron. So n means number of unpaired electron. So mu s value will be 0. 0 Bohr magneton. Right? Okay. So by the complex, we have to find the orbital arrangement, hybridization dsp2, right? Then the Bohr magneton value and geometry, square planar, right? These are the we have solved, right? Next, whereas nickel Cl4, actually the IUPAC name, tetrachlorido nickel A2. Nickel A2 ion. Right? Nickel A2 ion. Okay, here we have to find it which is paramagnetic. Right? So the same method we have to follow it. First, what you have to do then? As I told earlier, the chlorido is a ligand, right? The chlorido is a weak ligand. So each Cl minus 1, 4 Cl means totally minus 4. Minus 4. The nickel will be plus 2. So here, plus 2 minus 4 added means it gives minus 2. Here also, nickel gas, the oxidation state, plus 2. Right? So first, we have to write a nickel plus 2. Orbital arrangement. Just copy here. So d orbital, next s orbital, then p orbital, 3d, 4s, 4p, right? Now you can accommodate the electron. 3d, 8, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? Now the complex will form 4 chlorido involve the bonding with nickel. So nickel Cl4 minus 2. So again you can make the orbital arrangement. The Cl is a weak ligand. So weak ligand means the unpaired electron, it does not make a pair, right? So the arrangement, orbital arrangement is same like this. The 4 chlorido is involved in the bonding, the next of the 3d orbital, right? Because it does not involve the pairing of the electron, right? Because it is weak ligand. So first chlorine, second chlorine, then third chlorine, then fourth chlorine, right? Chlorine, Cl, right? Now, wherever the chlorine accommodate in the orbital of central metal atom, 1 s orbital and 3 p orbital, right? The hybridization we can get it. The hybridization is sp3 hybridization. So sp3 hybridization means geometry will be nickel will be center, Cl, 1 Cl will be top, right? The 3 Cl will be down, right? middle Cl is behind the bond like this. The structure that's called sp3 hybridization geometry like this. Tetrahedral geometry. Now, next, mu s also we can calculate it, right? Bond magnetic moment. So what's the formula? N into N plus 2 bond magneton value. Any unpaired electron present in the complex coordination compound, we have to find it. So here, 2 unpaired electron, we can get it. Just you apply here. So mu s equal to 2 into 2 plus 2 Bohr magneton. So what's the answer? Mu s equal to 2.83 Bohr magneton. Right? 2.83 Bohr magneton value. I hope you understand the valence bond theory. Right? So by this we can get it. NiCl4 is a diamagnetic, whereas NiCl4 is a paramagnetic. Right. So another one complex. The two types we have it. So one is a diamagnetic, another one paramagnetic. We are going to solve it, right? The complex is octahedral geometry. Octahedral geometry. Here the coordinate bond will be 6. 6 coordinate bonds will be there. So what are the complex you will see? Question number 2. Fe Cn6 minus 4. Right? Diamagnetic. Whereas Fe F6 minus 4 is paramagnetic. Explain. Right. So as we have seen earlier about the nickel complex, the same method we have to follow. It is iron complexes. Right. First I say the IUPACNA hexa, 6 means hexa, cyanido, ferrate 2 ion. Right. Here hexafluorido, ferrate 2 ion, right? First, I am going to solve this complex. First complex. First, you should find the central metal atom. Iron is the central metal atom. First, you write the iron. Iron, right? Iron atomic number 26. 26. So, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, then 2p6. 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d6. So once again we have to check the electronic configuration. 2 plus 2 plus 6, 10 plus 2, 12 plus 6, 18, 20, 26. Right? Now, what is the charge of the ion in the complex? So here each side is minus 1, 6 side is minus 6. I will be plus 2, added to minus 6 means totally minus 4. 4 necessary charge, minus 4, right? The ion charge, plus 2. Plus 2 means what? The last orbit, 4s2, will go out, right? According to alpha principle, I have written like this. I follow the alpha principle. You can write the electronic configuration. So last orbit, 4s2, the 2 electron will be released, right? So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, then 3d6, 4s will be 0. So now you return the 4s. 2 will return loose, right? Now, the orbital arrangement, fp plus 2 orbital arrangement, last orbit alone we have to take it, right? Because in the complex formation means last orbit, orbital only is involved in the bonding. So the 3d, so d orbital, 5 box. So next, s orbital, 4s. Next, p orbital, 4p. Right? Next, again on empty orbital, that is a d orbital. 4d. Right? Now, we can accommodate the electron 3d6. 3d. 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? Now we have 4 unpaired electron. 4 unpaired electron. But in the first complex, the Cn is a strong ligand. Strong ligand means unpaired electron make into pair. Right? So in the complex we see Fe, Cn, 6, minus 4, the unpaired electron tends to pair. So again we can write the orbital arrangement. Involved in the bonding. Now the hybridization we can find it. So how to find it?